It's behind the scenes in our favorite apps, making breakthroughs in the lab, and constantly in the news. Artificial intelligence is all around us. But how does it work? Let's shed some light on the world of AI. Artificial intelligence is an umbrella term that covers a wide range of systems that all work in slightly different ways. But many of the most widely known use mathematics to find patterns in data. These patterns are then used to make predictions. The most common forms of these AI systems use something called machine learning, where algorithms analyze data, arranging the patterns and features into models. You can think of models a bit like a map. Let's look at how a machine learning model might use an image of a koala. This image has millions of pixels. When we put this digital file through a machine learning model, these data points are processed via layers of multiplication and addition until patterns start to emerge for different features. You can think of these like islands. The more images we add, the more comprehensive the map becomes. Here on Koala Island, the west side of the island represents koalas with small ears, and the east, big ears. What's really mind-blowing is that ear size is only one feature. And to represent all of the different shapes, colors, moods, and compositions of koala images, we not only have to get 3D, but imagine thousands of dimensions. Maybe for now, let's keep it at just two. Now, if we take this map that's been trained with millions of koala images and ask what an image might look like here, an AI system can generate a completely new image related to that location. This is called generative AI. Amazingly, this mapping process works for any data, whether it's text, images, sound, whatever can be described with numbers. When we train models with these different data types together, it's a bit like combining two maps. Here, we have a text-to-image model, trained using images and their text labels. These models can take on complex tasks, answer questions, write poems and music, and even generate videos from scratch. But fundamentally, what we're doing is giving computer systems a way of mapping information and making connections between patterns. It's maths, not magic. So while these outputs are very convincing, it's important to understand that they're only a prediction based on training data. If we go back to our text-to-image map, and imagine that our text map was trained using American examples instead of Australian, this prompt might give us a much different result. Sometimes this can lead to something called bias, where unfair or unbalanced outputs are generated that amplify inaccuracies or gaps in the data. Take planning a playlist, for example. If an AI was trained using only your listening history, it won't have the right data to generate a playlist that appeals to everyone. It's important to remember that human and artificial intelligence are different things. For example, humans can instinctively understand context and apply common sense. AI systems approach things differently. That's one of the reasons it's important to understand how AI systems work, to ask questions and decide when and how we want to use them. In the right hands, AI systems can be incredibly powerful tools, helping manage huge data sets, see patterns that humans can't see, and automate complicated processes. But it's up to all of us to ensure it's being pointed at the brightest future possible. To find out more, check out CSIRO.au/AI.